you're gonna
bridge up. Bridge up.
Catch. Give up. Give up.
Bridge up.
Give up.
Nice. Nice. Hit. Relax. Nice. Beautiful.
Tonight looks immediately to take down Aung La and ducks.
Oh, that was so simple. He stepped in, got nice and tight, and immediately went in for the double leg. Now, this is really important for Aung La. He's got to push off the head, get his back up against that wall, and start working his way back up. De Ridder is very hard to stop once he gets that body.
Swipe your back across the cage this way.
Again, I talked about this before, like he took Aung La down, had that dead hip on the ground, and but Aung La is able to work himself back to his feet. So until there's still a scramble here.
Aung La, he's getting his back taken, Rich. You can see it. He's a little bit high, but you can see Aung La is doing a good job, but that hook's preventing him from doing it. Beautiful job now by Ritter to transition into half guard.
This is an established takedown fighter.
Top position for Reinier de Ridder, the challenger tonight. He's already the middleweight world champion, wanting to take Aung La's light heavyweight world title in half guard. Reinier cuts the hip in.
You can see Reinier de Ridder was trying to attack the kimura on that far side arm. Aung La knew what was going on. Aung La is very talented in jiu-jitsu. He knows what's going on. Now you can see de Ridder is trying to wrap up that neck.
Yeah, he's trying to sit out on that left hip there and reaching for the neck. He's looking for an arm in guillotine right here.
Man, these long arms of de Ridder are so difficult to deal with, especially when you try to scramble. He starts looking for darces and anacondas. Now he's attacking the arm here. Aung La easily takes the back, and there's that body triangle. It's like deja vu, Michael.
The same one from last time that captured in the middleweight belt. The body triangle wrapped around the midsection of Aung La N Sang. This is danger for Aung La.
Yeah, I'll say this about de Ridder taking Aung La's back. It's not as much as him taking the back, as much as it is that he forces his opponent, he forced Aung La to move in a position where Aung La gave him his back there.
Aung La's got to get to the other side. See how he's leaning to the knee side of de Ridder? He's got to try to get to the locked side, that foot side, which is the other side, so he can relieve some of that pressure. De Ridder's got a nasty squeeze inside that body triangle.
Still a long time to go, 2:45 remaining. First round set for five. It's all one-way traffic right now to RDR.
Yeah, Ridder does a good job with that left leg, lacing it behind or underneath the knee of Aung La inside the calf there. So like Mitch said, he's got to get that foot. He's got to get the Ritter's foot on the ground, but he's got to get that leg laced out first. And you can tell with the Ritter's long legs, like this is a very difficult position to deal with for him.
De Ridder said he would tap out Aung La inside of 3 minutes. How's the defense looking from Aung La tonight, Dragon?
It's better, but he's getting, De Ridder's a little bit high, and so he has to kind of reach down to attack the neck. And Aung La learned something from the first time. He's defending his neck very well, but De Ridder is not going after the face crank like he did last time. De Ridder's got a nasty squeeze, ladies and gentlemen. He's got a vice-like, slow, pressure-style grip. Aung La's got to be very careful, and De Ridder might go into mount here. Yep.
And those punches from de Ridder, you can hear those.
Arm triangle.
You can hear those from up here.
Aung La's got to clear that left arm. You can see he's trying to walk to the other
side. Ridder's turning. De Ridder's turning. Is this the end for Aung La N Sang? Is this it?
Give up.
Is this it?
Nice.
And Aung La holds on and he's out of trouble. That was close.
Wow.
That was razor close.
Oh, and he's,
wow, he's
out.
How about this? Here comes Aung La. Looks at the hammer fist. Will he allow de Ridder back to his feet so he can work the striking? Hammer fist there from Aung La. Side control, Aung La.
Wow, Aung La initiates back into the ground, jumps into the guard of de Ridder. No fear coming from Aung La.
Good right hand to the jaw there from Aung La with 1 minute to go inside the guard of the Dutch Knight.
Right there, right elbow over the top. Nice one.
Good left hand from Aung La. Should he be getting out of here? Should he be standing up?
I'm not sure why Aung La didn't back up and make de Ridder stand again, unless he thought, you know what, I can take the topside position here, and I'm not sure that I can defend the takedown again.
But he was easily comfortable down there. Maybe not easily comfortable, but he was able to maintain, survive two submission attempts, and do his work. He's like, all right, I'm not scared of you. I learned from the first time, Rich Franklin.
We're on the same page here, but all week we've been talking about how Aung La needs to keep this thing standing.
slinging the legs. Aung La N Sang, a turn of tide for the Myanmar superstar. De Ridder staying on his back. He does not want to get to the feet with Aung La. How taste my feet. Fires another up kick. Slings the legs again to Aung La. Final stages of the opening round. Most of it was for Reinier de Ridder, but then Aung La turned the tide. Defending champion Aung La N Sang. Challenger and middleweight world champion Reinier de Ridder. Body shot from Aung La. De Ridder immediately ties him up, scoots around to the back.
Man, he's so good at that. The way that he slips around to the backside like that, but Aung La's wise to it. Now he's got to defend. He's got to stop this single leg. De Ridder has beautiful transitions. It's not just his first attempt, but it's also the second and third coming from De Ridder. Aung La's got to get very heavy on the hips. He's got to separate that grip.
Man, you look at the damage that Aung La did to De Ridder's left leg on the outside. You can't see it from this angle, but he lit that thing up when he was standing in the guard right there.
Oh, sucked that leg in, pulled Aung La down to the mat, but Aung La's trying to work his way back up.
Still on my scorecard, guys, just so you know, I have not scored this as a takedown yet because he hasn't secured the takedown. Aung La still has the ability to get up here until De Ridder actually secures a position and begins to get offensive on the ground. It doesn't score.
Rich Franklin is not an official judge. He's just pretending to be one on TV.
Aung La momentarily glancing towards Olivia Coast, saying, you're going to break us, Olivia? There's no action coming from RDR at the moment.
This is a great tactic by Aung La. You saw it in the last match that he had with RDR when RDR had his back, and Aung La was looking at the referee like, he has nothing. He did the same thing against Big Dash as well, working the ref. That's veteran experience is what that is.
Man, just relentless. He goes after one, goes after the other, trying to get that single leg. Again, trying to pull out the knees, but Aung La is doing a good job of getting his legs back and then working his way back up the wall.
Uppercut from Aung La, beautifully placed on the inside, nice and tight. And another uppercut from Aung La as RDR dropped down for a single to execute a takedown.
De Ridder was getting ready for a match, but this was taken on short notice. So as this match hits those championship rounds, it's going to start to wear on him. He wasn't prepared for this type of work. I wonder if in his mind, the psychological effects of having those takedown defense defended, Rich, are starting to weigh heavily on his mind.
Absolutely, and you know, De Ridder here is working a lot for these takedowns. We've seen this earlier tonight. We saw it with Eddie Alvarez, this pressure against the fence. We've talked about this, Michael, and this takes a lot of energy out of you. And one of the things, one of the advantages that Aung La always brings to the circle is his conditioning. And so as this fight goes on to the deeper rounds, particularly the championship rounds, 4 and 5, that could be the difference maker.
There were a lot of questions, however, after the loss to RDR last time for the middleweight title, that Aung La had come back, of course, from a bout of COVID and how he'd managed to recover. There are still so many question marks about professional athletes recovering from COVID. Inside of half guard here with 2 minutes remaining, second round set for 5 of our light heavyweight world title main event.
Aung La goes to the body lock. He was trying to dig that underhook, but De Ridder was wise to it. So he framed out, switches his hips, postures out to that side. Now he's going to try to attack the Kimura as he steps over into mount easily.
Such a smooth transition to mount there. He did that so easily.
The elbows from the towering Dutch knight, dropping them down. Aung La's going to give his back. No.
Nice job to wall walk, though, out of that mount. And De Ridder was forced to step over. Now he's looking to take that back again. If Aung La can press his back up against that wall, he'll be able to defend this back take.
This is one thing that he does really well. Like, Aung La's always very aware of his surroundings, knowing when to use the cage wall, when to wall walk. He's able to, I mean, technically what he's doing there is wall walking with his right shoulder up. And this is what's able to get him back to his feet. He does such a great job of this. This is where his veteran experience really pays off in the circle.
Man, look at those legs of De Ridder. He has been only, Aung La has only landed a few leg kicks, but already you can see the welts as De Ridder easily transitions into the back again.
Puts the figure four, trying to lock it around the body of Aung La.
Fence, don't grab the fence.
What's he done here with his legs, Dragon?
Well, he's got one side, so he's got one hook in, and then he triangled. That's those legs of De Ridder. They're so long, and he's able to do things that most people cannot do.
Yeah, anytime that you're going to control the back, and De Ridder has a unique style here, but you always want your bottom leg to be the leg that has control, that's laced in with the hook. But then he does exactly what Mitch was talking about there, is creating a triangle, and rather than a body triangle, it's a triangle around the leg.
See how he used that to transition into side control? High-level jiu-jitsu, ladies and gentlemen, coming from Reinier de Ridder, the middleweight champion, as he's starting to soften Aung La up with the elbows as the 10-second clapper goes.
Side control here for RDR. Neon belly from the Dutch Knight drops the elbows on the forehead of Aung La N Sang against the middleweight world champion, Reinier de Ridder of the Netherlands. Rich, how do you see it after the first 10 minutes?
Yeah, after 10 minutes of action, de Ridder, in both rounds, he was able to land the takedowns, back control, and pretty much control the ground. Aung La had a minute to a minute and a half of shining at the end of the first round, but it wasn't enough to really close any kind of lead. So in my cards right now, de Ridder has a pretty significant lead, and if this trend continues, obviously he's going to go with the victory here. But this is still anyone's match, obviously, because we do not judge on a round-by-round basis.
Popping left hands there from RDR. Posting up that right arm. Aung La. Both men breathing hard here in the third. Lots of instructions coming from Henry Hooft and the team out of Sanford MMA from Florida in the corner of Aung La N Sang.
Also here. Are we doing the gym?
RDR dragging the Burmese python down, puts the hooks in, gets the back control. I expect the body triangle to come here pretty soon. You can see the way that RDR is trying to lace those hips. He's going to take that leg, wrap it around him, pins him into position. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, just creates a tight squeeze on Aung La N Sang. Not only is he holding him there, and it's hard for Aung La to really get out of this, but it creates pressure on the stomach, and it makes it very difficult to breathe. Aung La now needs to shift his weight to the foot side. You can see how RDR is trying to keep him to the knee side, which is his right side. Aung La needs to go to his left so that pressure starts to diminish on the squeeze that he has on his body, and also starts to relieve some pressure so he can get out.
We talked about Aung La doing a better job with defense here. Obviously, this choke that he's threatening, that RDR is threatening with here, he's not in any real danger yet. Oh, that was very crafty with the heel kicks to the stomach. Right?
It hurts me watching that.
But, you know, Aung La's got to be careful here. This is round three. We talk about the championship rounds. That's where he always shines. But little by little, this match is starting to inch away from him. And it may get to the point where it's so deep that Aung La will have to earn the knockout or the submission in order to actually win this thing.
RDR thought about an armbar, couldn't lock it on.
Got the gable grip there, going for a possible arm in.
Knees to the head of a grounded opponent, of course, are perfectly legal under the global rule set.
We saw the same thing with Gilbert Galvao when he went to that gable grip and started laying into those knees. But also what it gives him the chance to do is set this up. He's going to attempt now to go for a darsh choke as well. That enables him to wrap those long arms, and that's exactly what he's doing. See how he's sitting into it? He's got one arm. It's basically an arm triangle of inverted. So he's got that darsh choke. Let's see how Aung La defends this. He might transition and go for those knees with the gable grip. Back and forth tactics coming from RDR.
The knee that he planted on Gilbert Galvao was phenomenal. Trying to drive the patella into the side of the head here of Aung La.
Well, it's just the way that de Ridder has his control here. He's so heavy on top that in a situation like this, like Aung La is having trouble moving. But man, look at him showing, pulling right out of that. Amazing.
Tremendous from Aung La. Glances towards his corner. They're giving him instructions, trying to talk him through this predicament. Backed up against the fence. 120 remains, third round of five.
Yeah, Michael, you said it right on the head. He was trying to peel that arm off, just listening to his coaches, and Henry Hooft is just walking in through the steps he needs to do to just survive these positions. Beautiful job by Aung La to work his way back up to the feet, but this is not where he wants to be. Aung La does his best work when he's at distance. We can utilize that big right hand, uppercuts, overhands, and also those leg kicks. He's got to create some separation.
What's funny here is that the non-Dutch fighter has the Dutch style of striking. Dutch kickboxing, it's all Aung La.
Yeah, 45 seconds, let's go.
The man who is not called the python, squeezes like a snake.
30 seconds.
Yes, lifting up on that left arm, Aung La. 30 seconds remains now in this round. Another big round for Reinier de Ridder, but once again, as Rich reminds us, we are scoring this as a 25-minute overall bout and not as five seconds. Individual five-minute rounds.
Yeah, I've spent some time. I've spent quite a bit of time on the mats with Aung La. He's strong. So to see somebody like de Ridder just on top of him with pressure and Aung La having trouble moving him makes me wish I could have a grappling session with de Ridder.
I would have wished that on anyone.
Aung La N Sang put people away just like he did with Ken Hasegawa in that fifth round with that massive uppercut. Aung La N Sang is always in it, but he has to stop this.
And this just looks like a replay from the first match that they had with that takedown.
That one was slightly different, though. That was just a single leg. It quite wasn't up to the switch and the body takedown.
He didn't transition to the lock. You are correct.
20 seconds in, Aung La gets taken down, put on his back. You know, at this point in time, I don't know if Reinier de Ridder has any submission attempts that Aung La hasn't seen yet. He's always got a bag of tricks, so don't hold me to that, ladies and gentlemen. Reinier de Ridder is a submission master, but Aung La N Sang needs to change this. It's good for him to be in half guard. He's got to try to get that underhook on that left side and start moving. You can see how his back is flat against the mat right there. That's not a good spot for him. The way that Reinier de Ridder has that underhook and steps over into mount, that's a bad spot for Aung La.
I think part of the reason why de Ridder is able to step through like that is because his legs are so long. Like, you know, when Aung La brings that leg up from the bottom to try to protect himself from the step over into the mount, de Ridder's leg is just so long that he ends up missing it.
Shoulders up. De Ridder has the back of Aung La again, as he has every round. Will he slap on that triangle?
We're working on it. Go.
You can hear the heavy breathing, see the chest heaving of Aung La N Sang.
You can see how Aung La has kind of control the hands right there. He's got those hands nice and tight, so de Ridder can't pull the hand out and start attacking the neck. But just as I say that, de Ridder starts looking for the neck again. Aung La has definitely stepped up his submission defense, making it very difficult on Reinier de Ridder, but he's got to get out of this body triangle. He has got to start moving.
This body triangle will make it even harder for Aung La to breathe, to fill his lungs. And Reinier glances towards his corner now.
You talk about strategy of grappling as a fight wears on in the later rounds. Athletes, they're slippery. It's more and more difficult to lock in certain submission holds. And that's why this body triangle is really beneficial for somebody like de Ridder, because no matter how sweaty Aung La gets, you're just squeezed and trapped in that kind of thing. And so Aung La's going to have to really, really come up with some sort of real solution here, because this match really is starting to run away from him.
But Rich, we saw it in the third round. When Reinier de Ridder starts transitioning, starts to create these little bit of movements, Aung La was able to spin into the circle, which he's able to do right now.
Yeah, but de Ridder's not off that back yet. And there you have it. He breaks him right back down again. And that's the thing, you know, Aung La is an explosive athlete. He shows some glimmer of hope there, but that's just a testament to de Ridder's control and level of jiu-jitsu on the ground.
Hard strike to the side of the neck there from Reinier de Ridder. Triangle wrapped around the body again from the Dutch knight, under 2 minutes remaining in this penultimate round.
Full position.
What are the options for Aung La here, Dragon?
Well, he's got the pressure to the right side, so you can see that he's on the foot side. That's where his body weight is leaning. But the way that Reinier de Ridder has the leg triangled makes it even more difficult for Aung La to move. See how his left leg is kind of trapped there? Now he's doing a good job of removing that, but as I say that, Reinier de Ridder transitions into full mount. Now the arm is in a bad spot. Aung La needs to clear his right arm because Reinier de Ridder is trying to drop that head down. Good job by Aung La to recover that, but then Reinier de Ridder still on top.
What dominance from RDR on the ground today.
Fence.
He's mounted Aung La more times than a pommel horse. And you've got to wonder, what can Aung La do with 1 minute remaining in the fourth of five?
You know, I've been in these situations where you're just out grappled for a long period of time, you know? But it doesn't usually happen for 20 minutes solid where you're just outclassed. And you really have to step things up. But Aung La carries that power into deep rounds, so he still has the capability to put RDR's lights out. But if the past 20 minutes have been any indication, I expect the fifth round to just continue with this trend.
Yeah, we talk about Aung La's conditioning and how he performs in the championship rounds, but man, I mean, when you have somebody like de Ridder on top of you, I've never had de Ridder on top of me, but I'm picturing what it feels like based on what I'm watching here, and it's just a long time to carry that weight.
But you have been out grappled before.
When was that?
Never? You've never been out grappled?
I've never been submitted.
Vince again.
Not in a match.
Jeez, you're a brave man tonight, Mitch. I'll tell you what, a little cocky calling out Rich Franklin like that. Final seconds of the round. Sends him. Aung La N Sang. Reinier de Ridder. It's been all de Ridder so far, and he shoots in for a single early. Aung La's got to try and keep it on its feet. He stays vertical for the moment as Aung La.
I love it. Yeah, Aung La needs to start working in that underhook right there with the right arm like he just did.
And there's the takedown. Aung La on his back with de Ridder on top inside of half guard. Not where Aung La wanted to be within 30 seconds of this last round.
Yeah, Michael, it's just a master class from Reinier de Ridder, taking this match exactly where he wanted to, having very little resistance once this thing hits the ground, trying to pass the guard here. You can see how he has that left leg down there on the thigh. He's going to try to take his right leg, pop that through, and then just sit right into full mount. Good job by Aung La to kind of relieve that pressure from the mount.
I'm wondering where Aung La goes from here if de Ridder ends up taking this belt. Now de Ridder holds the belt in the light heavyweight class. He holds the belt in the middleweight class. And the question is, if Aung La actually had a full camp to prep for de Ridder, would that be the difference maker, because this was on a five-day notice?
You think a rematch is warranted?
Not at this point in time, but that's what I'm asking you. Where does Aung La go from here?
It has never been done in history for one man to take another man's titles in two weight divisions. Is Reinier de Ridder now 3 minutes and 30 seconds away from making history? He's in the full mount again.
Keep punching there. Keep punching. Be smart.
This would be a massive moment if de Ridder beats Aung La tonight. Shots to the side of the head from Aung La, but he's got to find a way to get off his back.
Yes.
Can Aung La get there now? Can he get to his feet?
Yes.
Top position for Aung La. Now has the pendulum swung.
Push his chin.
Push his chin, they're saying. Posture up, work the ground and pound.
Elbows, punches.
Nice job by Aung La N Sang to explode out of the mounted position, and now he's working from the top. He's got 2 minutes and 45 seconds to really put something together, because the lead, Rich, has got to be gigantic for RDR.
Yeah, it's huge at this point in time, and I agree with Aung La's decision to stay on the ground in the guard here, particularly after I saw that initial takedown defense that he attempted at the beginning of this round. But it's going to be difficult for him to get it done. It's going to be difficult for him to close the gap with enough damage or near finish or whatever. He's going to have to submit or knock out Reinier de Ridder in order to win this match with the amount of time that's left.
There is no quit in Aung La N Sang. There is no surrender in the Myanmar superstar. But time is now a big enemy for him. 2 minutes remaining for Aung La to try and find a finish, or history will be made by Reinier de Ridder. He will become the light heavyweight world champion, in addition to holding the middleweight world championship, something that's never been done before, to win both titles from the same man.
Frame his chin with your hand, like posture up. You've got to get your head up.
You hear them in the corner saying, frame his chin with your hand and posture up to work that ground and pound.
Get on your toes.
There needs to be more of a sense of urgency from Aung La's corner here. They have to know that this fight is slipping away from him second by second.
Drop the right elbow.
Close guard from RDR. Pulls the right hand out as Aung La can't land it cleanly, however. RDR closes down the posture again of the champion.
Yes.
You wonder if we are seeing the final 65 seconds of the reign of gold of Aung La N Sang, something that's become such an iconic part of one championship all around Asia. They love him everywhere we go. They turn out in force to support Aung La.
Look at the Ridder's mobility there.
Yeah, you can see how he's trying to overhook that arm and then trying to just get his hips outside to attempt possibly an arm bar. He's very mobile off his back. But at this point, he's got 30 seconds left. He's got a massive lead in just ground control and aggressiveness.
But that's what I like about the Ridder. He's got 30 seconds left. He's clearly dominated this entire match, and it's not good enough for him. He's saying, nope, I want this submission. I want something.
Aung La's trying. He's trying to land a heavy salvo in the final seconds, but again, those long arms reach up. They pull him down. They control the posture. He closes the guard. RDR shutting down Aung La N Sang. We are going to a decision here in Singapore in our main event. We may see the title change hands. Heavyweight world champion, Reinier.